Welcome to the demo of the second release of PharmaStatus. My name is Anne van den Broeke. I work at the Federal Agency for Medicines and Health Products. Together with my colleague Sophie Bruneel, we have been working on the extension of this application. PharmaStatus is an online application that collects information about the availability of medicines in Belgium. This presentation is meant to give an overview of the changes compared to the previous version. It will not cover all functionalities of PharmaStatus. The complete manual is available on the website. Publication of available and unavailable medicines. In the previous version, only information on unavailable medicines was published. From now on, you will also find information on available medicines and medicines that are new on the market. For each medicine, we indicate the current status and, if applicable, a future modification. Keep me informed about a medicine or group of medicines regardless of any existing unavailability. Before, you could be kept informed about a current unavailability. This was linked to a specific medicine. The procedure ended when the medicine was available again. In this new situation, you can be kept informed about a medicine or group of medicines regardless of any existing unavailability. So that means that you can pre-register to be informed on future changes in the availability of a medicine or group of medicines. The procedure ends if the user chooses not to receive updates anymore. For example, a patient takes medicine for chronic use, Depakine-Chrono. He can do a search on the name and he can click on Keep Me Informed. Other example is influenza vaccine. So pharmacists want to be informed about the availability or problems with influenza vaccines. They can do an advanced search via ATC code. They get the list of all pack sizes that are published on PharmaStatus, and they can subscribe to be kept informed about this search query. From now on, they will receive a mail of any change in the availability of one of these pack sizes. In this release, we offer the possibility to pharmacists and wholesaler distributors to send a message to the authorization holder or parallel distributor. They can only send a message if the medicine is listed as available, but they suspect that it is nevertheless unavailable, or if the medicine is listed as unavailable, but the presumed end date of the unavailability has expired. In other cases, it is not possible to open and send a form. Very important is that the form can only be used for notifications about unavailabilities or problems regarding the delivery. The form is not intended for any other purpose. Here you see an example. Medicine is indicated as available, but they have problems by commanding the medicine, so they can click to the link reported to the pharmaceutical company. A form opens that can be completed. Here they have a choice between predefined messages, but if needed, they can also fulfill a free text field by clicking on others. The values shown for wholesaler distributors differ slightly from the values for the pharmacist in accordance with the legislation. They can also indicate if they place the order directly at the company distributor or if they place the order at the wholesaler distributor. New in this section, accessible for pharmaceutical companies, is an overview of all medicines of the authorization holder parallel distributor linked to the profile of the user. This includes also medicinal products that are not yet commercialized. For each line, you will find the current and future status. In this list, of course, you can perform additional searches according to the information you are interested in. There are also some improvements and modifications on the notification procedure. After sending a notification, the data are transferred to the internal database. Only after validation, data are updated in pharma status. During that process, it is not possible to send a new notification for this specific medicine. From now on, this is shown visually by the statement in progress. So as long as in progress is shown, an update of the medicinal product is not possible. In the notification form, you can make a selection to only see the packages that are commercialized in the drop-down. It can be a rather long list, so in case you want to notify a temporary unavailability, it might be useful to indicate that you can only see the commercialized medicines. On the notification forms, there are two new fields. In case of an interruption of commercialization, the field unavailable until, so the presumed end date, is mandatory. A completely new field is the current stock in case of a temporary unavailability and an interruption or stop of the commercialization. We are aware that this is a moment's notice and it will only be used to evaluate the unavailability at the moment of the notification. So there is no need to send updates of this field. The update of a previous notification is possible via the medicine details screen. Via this screen, you can easily see the current and future status notifications. You can modify the notification, cancel a future notification, make the medicine available again, or make a new notification for this medicine. The options that are shown depend on the current and future status of the medicine. Here you can see an example. If you click on Show More, you will see more information about the notification you made earlier. You can easily modify the notification, make the medicine available again, or make a new notification. An example. Here we have two statuses, so current status and the future status. Current status is temporary unavailable, so the actions that are possible are to make it available again or to modify the notification. In case of a future status, you can modify or cancel the notification. We often get a question how they have to adjust a temporary unavailability that lasts longer than 1 year. If you want to do it, you have to change the status temporary unavailability to interruption of commercialization. A notification of a temporary unavailability and an interruption of commercialization are two different notifications. So to do so, you have to make a new notification by clicking on New Notification on top of the screen. Then you select Interruption of Commercialization and the temporary unavailability will be closed automatically. From now on, it will also be possible to cancel a future temporary unavailability. Of course, once the start date is reached, the temporary unavailability cannot be cancelled anymore. How can I reply to messages sent by pharmacists or wholesaler distributors? You can find the messages via the homepage in the section Notification and Messages, Recent Notifications and Messages, and All Messages. New messages are put on top of the screen. Closed messages for which you sent an answer are put in the section Closed Messages. How do I reply on these messages? First of all, you have to select the medicine product. All unanswered messages related to this medicine product are listed at the bottom of the webpage. By clicking on View Detail, you can see more information about this message. You can select one or more messages for which you want to send an answer. You can send the same reply to several messages by clicking the relevant messages on the left and by clicking on Send Reply to selected messages. Afterwards, you get the response field, then you can complete. Click on Send and the message will be transferred to the section Closed Messages. Pharmacist or wholesale distributor will receive the answer by mail or in Pharma Status in their section My Messages. Automatic alert in case of unanswered messages from pharmacists and wholesale distributors will be sent to the main user of the pharmaceutical company on a daily basis. There is only one mail for all unanswered messages. The number of messages is mentioned in the mail. The mail is sent as long as there is at least one unanswered message. In the mail, you can find a link to Pharma Status that will send you to the section All Messages. There is also a new or adapted SIPS system for the automatic mail in case of unavailabilities of which the presumed end date is expired. The mail is sent to the user who notified the unavailability once a day. And there is one mail for all expired notifications. So this replaces the current alert system of one mail for each expired notification. The mail is sent as long as there is at least one unavailability with an expired presumed end date. So here you see that the medicines are listed in the mail and there is a link to the page of the concerned medicine and Pharma Status. So these are the most important changes of this new release. If you have any questions or comments, you can contact us via mail database@fagg.be. We thank you for your attention and we thank you for your cooperation.